We will see what an eco valve is and why it is used in the front load washers. I think most of you must not be aware of what is an eco valve. But those who know, then, well and good. First, let me explain where the eco valve is installed in the front load washer. Now I have kept both machines upside down on the floor. This washer is from Kenwood Company. The washer having an eco valve starts from here and ends here. But this front load washer has no eco valve in it. Other than this, this washer has an eco valve installed in it. Let me show you by opening both of these water rubbers and explain what the difference and how an eco valve works. Now, let's open it up. I have opened this rubber. This rubber is without an eco valve. The rubber I opened before had no chance of water dropping on the motor. Here in this machine, the chances of water dropping on the motor are 99%. For that purpose, I am covering the motor with a plastic bag. Now I am using a bowl so that the water drops inside it. Water was inside the machine but a little. The air trap system of the washer is also attached with the rubber. I will remove this clip as well. Now the rubber has opened, and this is the washer's air trap. This is the rubber that I have opened from the Kenwood washer. This is a very simple rubber. A hole is made inside for passing the water. It has no something special inside it, which can be called an eco valve. Now let's talk about the next rubber, but it is not a rubber. It is a complete valve, but how am I saying that it is a valve? Let me explain to you. The simple rubber has no air trap installed with it. The air trap inside that washer is installed in the other place. The air trap system is installed with this hose of rubber. This is its air trap system. But its valve is beneath the air trap. You can see a ball beneath the air trap. Now, this ball controls the water flow. I am going to explain this by experimenting with it. Now to make you understand, I am going to do a small experiment. I blocked both the hose's faces with a plastic bag so that the water could not flow. And now I will pour some water inside it. But before doing it, see that the rubber from here is slightly tilted. But as we have to understand it's working, we have no concern with it. Now let's understand how this valve works and what its purpose is. Let's pour water inside it. It is filled with water now. It is working as a valve now. But how? See, when I press this ball downwards, and as soon I release it, it comes back. It is working as a valve now. We have understood now that it is working as a valve now. But why is it called eco valve? It is called an eco valve because the water which flows upside in the drum and the drain water that goes inside the drain. This eco valve is used to separate both water sections in the washer. Now, what are its benefits? It is beneficial in two ways. The first benefit is when the water flows through the eco valve and goes down, it closes. The detergent gets mixed with water in the drum. The water with detergent doesn't get mixed with the downside of the rubber pipe. This means it is economical. That's why the word eco is used. This prevents the surf from mixing with the extra water. And thus, it is called an eco valve. The second benefit is when the washer is working in the heating mode. In the heating mode, the water above the eco valve gets heated. The water down the eco valve does not get heated. The water in washers with no eco valves also heats the extra water. When the water vibrates, then it mixes. As the heat is transferable, that's the reason this valve is used here. This way, the washer with an eco valve will be economical with detergents. And it will be more efficient in heating the water. If you have understood all the concepts, give this video a thumbs up. And this is for this video. I will see you at the next one. Click on the left or right thumbnail on the screen to watch out next videos. And subscribe. It's free. Thank you.